All right, we're here with head coach Beth Alford-Sullivan after the Commodore Invitational. Coach, what are your thoughts on the sprints today?
Oh, the sprints were great today. I mean, clearly we've been excited to open Chris Coleman in the 60, and he took care of business there without any problems. But it really is a phenomenal breakthrough for Moose to come on and do what he's doing, and two guys running that fast this early is very, very exciting and very, you know, just a great credit to the great teamwork that Chris provides, the leadership, but also just how Moose Akeem has just stepped up and gotten closer and closer. We also had a great run out of Malik Elion, too, on that. And then on the women, we're really looking to turn the corner as we end out January and go into February. Big breakthrough from Dominique Turner. A week ago, her opener was 870. This week, she runs 840. I mean, I think that's going to continue to drop and really put herself into some good contention as a true freshman in the hurdles. And then you saw Shania Collins and Maya McCoy once again just continue to fight for things. Lanice Dyer gave us a much better weekend as well. And then the relay topped it off on the women. We rested the guys, but on the women, you know, really, they came on very strong, ran faster than I was expecting at 3:39. So very competitive and very focused group. And give a shout out to Ari Cogdell as well with a great opener on, or a great 400 on his open 400. So across the board, I don't know if I'm missing anybody, but the sprints really, you know, as we move through this month, I think we should continue to see those competitive times and those things get stronger and stronger.
And then a big day yesterday from Daryl Sullivan. He kind of led the jumps this week. What did you think about
Daryl? Yeah, Daryl looks very good. You know, he cleared the 6:15. That's a freshman record for us at Tennessee, and I'm sorry, the 2:15, got that freshman record and over the 7-foot barrier. And so, you know, I think his confidence is high. He's feeling very good, and again, just some more experience and more jump time will take him up another notch. Throws as well were very good. Stan Mateo really leading the charge there. PRs in both the weight and the shot put, and very competitive fire. I was able to watch both of those events and had great competitive fire there, and she's really leading the charge on the young women in that group too, in the weight throw especially. So we're thrilled with how everybody is rounding out. Our distance squad as well really moved a lot of momentum forward from a week ago to this week, and that's just, you know, getting their sea legs underneath them, getting some track time, you know, training going. We just had been back in school or back to training 3 or 4 days before Indiana. Now we've had a week and a half and a second race on them. So everybody moved forward. Big breakthrough race on Zach Long. You know, so we're thrilled with really across the board. I think it ended up 22 or 24 personal bests and season best, those kinds of things. So you come here and have that kind of opportunity with the team is really, really good. The other thing that we did that I thought we did well with was to be in this environment and to know what to expect as we come back here for the SEC Championship. So Vanderbilt put on a great meet, and we'll be thrilled to come back and feel a lot more comfortable getting in this facility. It's a unique facility, and so it'll be good for us to have done this and prepare over the next, you know, 6 weeks or so to get ready.